Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to create better text wrapping in Pages using shapes. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you want to wrap text around an image, you don't always want it to wrap around the complete rectangle of the image. For instance, let me take this picture of a car and bring it in to Pages here. I'm going to shrink it a bit and you can see it's going to use the rectangular shape of the image itself to wrap the text around it. There's a lot of white space here. Now you can use a technique here to create an alpha channel with all this white space. If I go to Format, Image, and then Instant Alpha, I can click here and then use that white space as a transparent part of the image, and then I get the ability to have the text wrap around the object itself. But this doesn't always give you perfect results and sometimes you want to customize it. So let me show you how. I'll undo here so it's a rectangle like this. And let's say I want to put this in the middle here and I want to have the text wrap around nicely. So what I'm going to do is actually go to Format, Arrange, and set the text wrap to None. Now I'm going to go to Shape and I'm going to click the Pen tool here to create a custom shape. I'm going to draw a shape using clicks to draw dots around the image. I can draw it however I want. I can include parts of the image or not include parts of the image. Now I've got this shape here and I can use this shape here as the thing to wrap text around. So for instance, if I were to set this to Around, you can see the text is actually going to wrap around this shape here. Now this may already be something you want. You may not actually want to have an image in there, but actually kind of cut out a hole in the shape of an object. In that case, all you need to do is go to Style, change the line to No Border, and then you end up with nothing there. But if you want to have this actually appear inside of that, you can. I'm actually going to delete this original image here and drag the car into the shape. And now you can see that this is going to appear inside the shape. I need to shrink it to fit. So I'll resize it like that. Done. And now I've got that image inside of the shape. I'm going to go back to Format, Arrange, and set the shape to wrap around like that again. So this is actually a shape that I have customized. If I double click, you can actually see the line there. So not only is the text wrapping around this shape here, but the actual image is being cropped. So the white part outside the car is actually not appearing outside of the shape. So it's not blocking the text either. And you can actually see the gray text here. That's text that would actually be hidden by the car if it wasn't for the fact that the car was inside of a shape. So this next example is a little different. First, I want to turn on page thumbnails so we can see all the page thumbnails here. I'm going to add an image to the background behind the text. So this is an image of a plane flying over water. And what I want to have is the text that is actually flowing on top of the water, but the plane looks like it's pushing the letters away. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stretch this image here to fill the entire page. I want to move it behind everything. In order to do that, I need to put it behind on the section layout. So move object to section layout. That's going to put it in the section layout for all the pages in the section. So what I eventually am going to do is I'm going to create a new section. So page one is one section and then page two and on is another section. But I'll show you that once we're done because I want to see exactly how much text is used here. So I want the text to flow around the plane. In order to have that done, I'm going to create a shape. Shape with the pen. I'm going to draw exactly where I want the text to wrap around. And I want it to go all the way to the bottom of the page. So it's not really going to follow the image at all. So you can see how the area here below the plane is actually going to be pushing the text away. Whereas if I was using just an image of the plane, the text might wrap up underneath here. So I can adjust all these points as much as I want, and I can click off of it and then on it again to select it as an entire object. Go to Format, Arrange, set it to Wrap Around. So you can see how the text now flows on either side. Let's make the text a little bit more like what we want, which would be larger, white to go against the blue background there. Maybe bold. So now you can read it easily here on the background. I can take the shape here. I can go to Style and set it to No Border so it's invisible. So now this text wraps around the plane using the shape, and the plane is just part of the image in the background. So let's say we'll cut the text short right here. I'm going to insert a section break. So now this goes to the second section here. I can then go to Arrange, Section Layouts, Make, Layout Objects Selectable. So now I can select the image here, and you can see it's separate from the image here because this is section 1, this is section 2, and page 3 is section 2 as well. So I can delete this off of that section. I can also select all this text here all the way till the end, and I can make that black there. So you can see now the reason I waited till the end to do that was because I wanted to make sure I knew exactly where all this was going to end. Now another thing I may want to do is, since I'm dividing text up, it's a little hard to read. So I'm going to go to Section Layouts and turn this off. I'm going to select the text again, and I'm going to make it two columns. So Layout and add a column to it. That allows one column to wrap on one side, one column to wrap on the other. This actually pushes some more text over here. So I want to, you know, readjust that, put the section break a little earlier, remove that section break. But you get the general idea. It's actually this shape here that is pushing the text away, not the image at all. But it allows me to do something really creative, even though I can't use an alpha channel and I can't use the shape of the object or anything like that to have the text wrap around. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.
If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.